the great shepherd leader of the Wildcats.
Oh yeah.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Carson Palmer for the Cardinals.
Carson Palmer's went to USC.
Stinks the worst in the huddle. Hey, what's up, Prophet?
How you doing? You
bringing the fire tomorrow?
Yes, sir.
How much fire? What's the temperature going to be? Yeah. So this is Garcia right here, my favorite Garcia in the whole wide world. So Garcia, tell me something you did good today.
Something I did good today.
That was encouraging to somebody today. What did you do that was good today?
Well, I went and ate lunch with my little sister today.
All right. Yeah. Had lunch with his little sister today. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Pretty good, my man. Wildcats, we're more than just football players.
Yes,
we eat lunch with little people.
What about you? How's your heartbeat get during games?
Dude, I think it's probably twice the rate.
Twice the rate?
Because I'm excited to watch y'all play every Friday night.
How's it feel to be all access?
How's it feel to be all access? I feel defiled.
Let it be known that Joey and I one time played handball.
And I beat him.
And he whipped me.
I beat him bad. Beat him like a rented mule.
He did.
And why we have Thursdays? See, I see it in some of your faces. Some of you go, why do we got to come in here on Thursday? Well, because you're learning about life. And you learn about life through Christ and how God has made us. And you want to know what God's like? God's like this. He gives us all to us. And he wants us to live like that for him. You know what I'm saying? Because it's the best way to live.
First got here in the year 2000, a couple of players came up and said, hey, Coach Donahoe, we've got a guy that's really special here that's really helped us a lot. Is there any way we can keep him around? I said, who are you talking about? They said, well, his name's Joey Butler.
The first time that I met Joey, we were just standing out on the field, and you know, he introduced himself, and Coach Donahoe introduced us, and the first thing that he asked me was, is there anything I can do for you?
You know, him checking on you, are you having a good day, you know, and making you feel like you're having a good day, even if you were having a bad day. All of a sudden, you get done talking to Joey, the day just got better.
And I would be having a hard practice, and things aren't going right, and he'd just come down, and that just emotional lift that he would give me, just being there was huge.
Being, you know, being a new staff member a few years ago, and have him, you know, come down on the field on one of those first Thursdays, and come up and shake my hand, and call me by name, and know who I am when, you know, I'm going through a few weeks of, you know, just trying to fit in with the staff and not knowing quite where my place is.
It was amazing to me, a man of the service that he was, how many people he was able to reach. And with this program, obviously, he meant a lot to our kids. He was able to reach many of our kids and help them be headed in a positive direction.
That the guy made you want to be better.
I remember one of the first times that I was here, and he was doing a Thursday lesson. We were preparing for Rockhurst, and he took the kids down kind of to the little creek area in that bottom parking lot, and he pulled out a sledgehammer. It was about, you know, pounding the rock and just keep pounding it until it breaks. And I remember Kelly seeing that sledgehammer come out and kind of getting a little worried about his kids swinging this big old sledgehammer around. But you know, that was one of the first experiences I had, and just seeing how he interacted with kids, and you know, that was great.
One of the most meaningful times to me was when he was with our kids in the winner's manual. And he always had tremendous words and stories to tell our kids, you know, that was able to reach their minds and their hearts and change them in a positive way.
He's just the most giving person about understanding what life is all about, that it's never about you, it's about serving others.
I don't think you have the ability to measure what Joey has meant to the program. I mean, you take into consideration all the people that he touched, between coaches, administrators, the kids, obviously, parents. You know, he's reached so many people.
I mean, you realize what a good man he is, and how he, you know, I always feel like he's the kind of guy that just keeps you sharp and helps you get sharper.
And he makes you feel important when he doesn't even realize maybe the struggles that I might be going through.
But every time you talk to him, you feel like you're learning a lesson.
And it's amazing to me because a dear friend of both of ours one time told me about a conversation they had not too long ago. In that conversation, Joey was asked the question, what do you fear? And Joey thought for a little bit, and he said that I haven't been able to serve enough people. and that's the type of person he is. You know, he was always in of service.
Or just the way he lived his life, he was always teaching us something. And, you know, when we talk to our kids about words like adversity and perseverance and sacrifice, you know, those are things that we talk to them about, lessons on the field, but those are lessons that Joey was teaching us while he was living through everyday life.
And you can see a little bit of Joey in all the guys on the team.
The impact he's had on our players, our coaches, has been immense.
He brings out that desire to want to be a better person, and you see that in kids.
My son was struggling a little bit, and I said, Joey, will you talk to him? And Joey said, sure, I'll talk to him. And Ryan was kind of trying to stay away from him, and Joey goes, I'm going to hunt him down. I'll find him.
One of the things that he talked a lot about on Thursdays going into our Friday games was the best is yet to come.
You know, Joey always talked about to our kids about buttoning the top button. You know, when you button the top button of your shirt, you know, all the other buttons tend to fall in line. And, you know, when you look at Joey, you look at the way he lived his life, you know, Joey's faith and his family came first. And then everything else kind of tend to fall in line. I think as a man, you know, that's something to aspire to.
The impact he had on my life alone was remarkable. I mean, love the man. And, you know, it's cool to be able to, like, look up, you know, yesterday and look at him and know he's shining down on you because you know that he made a difference. And it's a challenge because you know, he's always looking down on you now, so to continue that legacy and the things that he gave the time to us, for us to give that time to the people now.
I think the thing that is really nice is that about 3-4 years ago, you know, Coach, we put that big mural down there on the stairwell, and that's that one where the players run out. It's got Ty as one of the leaders running out, but I think what is so cool about that is it's a picture from the field of the guys coming out of the school, down the ramp, running onto the field. Bands playing, you can tell the students are going crazy, and all 100 and some kids are down there. Some are running, some are getting ready to start running down, and there's Joey, and he's standing up there at the top by the school looking down, and it's like that shepherd, and there's his flock, and he's watching over them. And I always thought that was so awesome to have that mural. And every day walking up that stairwell to be able to see Joey is going to be a really special thing. I'm just so excited that what he's taught us and brought to us over all these years we can carry for a long, long time in our program.